First, it's been an absolutely huge week for our own solar system. We discovered a potential new dwarf planet and an asteroid with a ring system. The catchingly named 2012 VP113 is the newest member of our solar family. This new object is thought to be part of a region called the Oort cloud, and it orbits the Sun in the most distant known trajectory so far. 10 years ago, an object named Sedna was discovered, which stretched our previously defined solar system boundaries. VP113 has the most distant known trajectory, but that doesn't mean it's consistently the most distant known object. It has a highly elliptical orbit and doesn't always stay beyond Sedna. Its closest point to the Sun, however, is 80 astronomical units, which is further than Sedna's 76 astronomical units. More exciting news for our solar system, we discovered the first confirmed ring system around an asteroid. This is the smallest object ever found to have rings, and only the fifth body in our solar system found to have them. The asteroid is called Chirriclo, and the discovery was made entirely by accident. Chirriclo recently eclipsed a star, and the astronomers using telescopes at 7 different locations were able to watch the star apparently vanish for a few seconds as its light was blocked by the asteroid. But for a few seconds before and again for a few seconds after the main event, they saw 2 very short dips in the star's brightness. In addition to the expected drop in apparent brightness, double rings have also blocked the light. By comparing observations from different sites, the international team reconstructed the shape and size of the asteroid, along with the shape, width, and orientation of the newly discovered double rings. The astronomers also believe that it's likely that Chirriclo has at least one small moon still waiting to be discovered. Over in biology, meet Tomiskia caris borealis, a newly described fossilized creature from Greenland that lived around 520 million years ago. Like certain types of modern whale, it possessed large appendages that were used to filter plankton and other small organisms from the ocean. These animals belonged to a group called anemolocarids. Anemolocarids were traditionally known as giant apex predators who used similar appendages as those possessed by Tomiskia caris to capture large prey. Intriguingly, Tomiskia caris borealis seems to have actually evolved filter feeding equipment from these prey-capturing appendages during the Cambrian explosion. More in biology, scientists have matched 2 halves of a fossilized turtle bone that have been separated for more than 100 years. Putting the 2 halves together means they've finally been able to estimate the size of the animal, and they found it was an astonishing 3 meters in total length. The turtle lived 70 to 75 million years ago during the Cretaceous period. And finally, scientists have synthesized the first synthetic eukaryotic chromosome. They designed and synthesized a fully functional chromosome of baker's yeast from scratch. And when they placed the synthetic chromosome into living cells, the yeast happily took it up. They fused together tiny snippets of synthetic DNA to build a computer-designed derivative of the chromosome. So far, the team has only synthesized 1 of the yeast's 16 chromosomes, but the work makes it possible to build an entire eukaryotic genome. By recombining the DNA in different ways, they hope to engineer yeast that can make ethanol or biofuels, or grow better in difficult environments, or maybe even turn them into tiny factories for anti-malarial drugs or vaccines. Their ultimate goal is to create a whole synthetic yeast genome. That's it from me this week, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next week.